This telescope is kind of cheap telescope because the price goes from 80 to more or less about 100-110 with a few bucks. You can try this telescope. You can see some good and nice things with this telescope. And then, if you want to upgrade, you will know better what you want. And this one that was cheap, you can use it and continue to use it. I will tell you how I do it. This telescope came with a diagonal. It's this part. That is nice because it's a round one, and it's very easy for everybody, the children included, to play with this telescope. Comes with a 3x Barlow, which I didn't use because it's a mess. Just put it apart, and came with 20 millimeters and 4 millimeters eyepiece, two eyepieces. The 4 millimeters I also put it apart because isn't worth it to try it. It will gonna mess your views. But the 20, you can try it. I only use the 20 when I received this telescope. It's the first eyepiece and the unique that you should use when you receive this telescope. Set up this is very easy. You just have to adjust your 8. And then this have here something to screw and tight, and this part only is about putting screws, tightening the screws, and then this part too you have to put this here. It's about two or three screws. It's nothing to worry about, and it has instructions. Fortunately. It comes with a finder. This finder that I have upgraded, it's a 90 degree. It's better, but only because of being 90 degrees. So you, for your neck and the children to come here and see, it's easier. Rather, if you point in too much up to the zenith or so, you have to, with the original finder, you have to find like this. So I upgraded, but after that I also upgraded to a Regal, which I recommend. I also recommend to, if you want to upgrade the finder, if you are not happy, to upgrade first this, and then if you want to upgrade this. This is a cheap 90 degrees finder because, in my opinion, isn't worthy to spend a lot of money in this kind of first scopes or little scopes. Because to spend money, you will save it to spend in the scope upgrade, in the good one. 2 inches eyepieces and things like that. But all of this you will keep using. Don't worry, it will not go to the trash. So the Regal is like a Telrad. It's a finder. It's like a Telrad. The Telrad is better for me. The price is similar. But the Regal is better for little telescopes because it's more proportional. No, the Telrad is big. I have a Telrad in the 12 inch, and it's big. It's good for a big telescope, and it has a nice field of view to see from apart. This one you have to see. I will show you. This is very easy to work with. You turn on, and it has some circles here. Two circles, I think, the Telrad S3, two circles, and you just point it to the target, and when it's aligned, you have to align, like the finder, when it's aligned, you will see through the eyepiece, and it's so easy to find the objects with this. The children love the feeling, you have the red dot circles. It's very nice. So what I did was to buy this for this telescope. I put it here in this position because I think it's the best position, because sometimes you have to be closer to the Regal to see better. So it's a fair position. It doesn't mess with the weight, but also this is a lightweight. I only put two clamps here, that regular clamps that you use in the garden or whatever. And I put two clamps because this has glue, some tape, but to fix it and avoid someone to knock it out and it falls or break, I put it like this with these two clamps. So to the question of the finder, you will work with your finder. If you want to upgrade, you buy the Regal. You can use it later in another telescope if you want. It was a better deal, this Regal, rather than this Seven. Seven, it's the name of the company. It's a German company. It's okay, but it's hard to keep it fixed and aligned. So, about the eyepieces. Don't start buying a lots of eyepieces and people, I ask, should I buy this eyepiece? Should I buy one better? Remember, you will be buying one and a quarter eyepieces. Later, if you like this, you will want to have a bigger telescope. And you will like to have 2 inches eyepieces. You will not use the one and a quarter for long, because you will note the 2 inch are much better. Have a true field of view bigger and it's better. So what I recommend, strongly recommend to buy with this telescope or similar. This review is also for people that has similar telescopes. This is a 70 millimeters aperture. It's in the lowest range of a decent telescope, first telescope to have. Lower than that, I don't recommend it. It's a hobby killer. This is not a hobby killer. This will put you and your children willing to see more and to improve the astronomy knowledge. Mainly that's why I think it's a good first telescope and it's easy to work with. So the eyepiece I bought, and I strongly recommend, it's a zoom eyepiece. It's up to you if you want to buy a good zoom eyepiece, okay, or a cheaper one like this one. I bought the cheaper one. It works well. It's a nice eyepiece. So if you don't want to spend a lot of money, which probably you don't, because some eyepieces cost more than the scope itself, so you will use a regular zoom eyepiece. Any zoom eyepiece, it's good for this scope. That's my opinion. So go for cheap and you will be fine. With this eyepiece, you have 24 and all the millimeters down to 8. I also bought a Barlow, the cheap Barlow. It was not a good Barlow for this one. For the other I have, I bought a very nice Barlow. But for this one, a cheap Barlow is enough, because it doubles to 4 millimeters. So you will have one more to 4 millimeters. I made a kind of cheap improvement, but this is very nice. Just tell you first how it works. This knob is an azimuth knob. I have always this knob released. So you can see that I work like this. I don't need to have this completely locked. And it's one less thing to worry about managing. This is very practical and simple telescope if you know how to use it. Now, for the latitude, up and down, no? You have here, these knobs have to be tight. And this is the one that you release and goes up and down, you see? And when you catch the object, you lock it. And then they have here fine adjustment. If you turn this with this lock, it will go a little bit up or a little bit down. It's just a fine adjustment. Also, you have here the focuser. No, you have to focus here. So the first thing is to take this out, the capsule out, and then you release. This is tight. You release this and you find the object. For example, the moon. You go to the moon, you lock it, the silver one, you lock it. It's on the moon, okay? Then you can adjust here, or you can adjust the fine adjustment here. Well, and you have to focus. Just don't forget to do this. What I did was, because this with a lot of use, you will note that these two knobs will start to release. So what I did was a very simple thing. This was the original knobs of the telescope. This measures about 1.5 centimeters, so 15 millimeters. This was here, and that was the cause of the problem. It was one here and one here. What I did was, I bought these roller washers. I will show you. You have here, you can see. So this works like a sandwich, no? Like a sandwich. The roller washer stays inside. This fits here. And what it does is that you, everything that is here will turn around, but not unscrew. This is like, if you have a scope Dobsonian, this is like the washer that you have in a middle knob, azimuthal, of the rock box of the Dobsonian, the base. So this is equal. This is a M8 measure. So I bought a little bag. It's a cheap thing to buy. So it's a nice improvement and a cheaper one. So what I did was to buy this and these knobs. These knobs are equal to this one, but this have 2 centimeters, 20 millimeters to change for the old ones. And I changed the two, and I put here the two with the washer, two, one here and the other side equal. Here, I took them off, I put the washer, I screw, and then tight well. And if you can see, this is well tight. And what happens is, I do like this, and the knob turns around also. It's the same system of the Dobsonians. So you can use it all night, and you don't have to be always adjusting here. So you eliminate the azimuth problem, the altitude problem here, and you will only work like this, which is very simple, and lock with a silver one. You don't need nothing more. You just work like this. You just work like this, and for the children, it will be easier to teach them, because you say you only have to, when you find the planet, you lock it like this. And this, okay, this is a shift telescope. Always have some kind of tilting, but if you knock and don't touch, this will not tilt. If you don't touch anything, that will be great. So this is a very nice improvement. I strongly recommend if you want to use this scope. I still using this scope. I mainly use my 12-inch Dobsonian, of course. But if you have a night with a bad weather, and you know that will be impossible to put the scope out, almost raining, cold, a lot of clouds, and sometimes you can see a star in the middle of the clouds, so you just put this light telescope there, take the caps, point, and you see the nebula, or the moon, or Mars, or Jupiter, or Saturn. It's beautiful. Saturn, you show first, if you can, to your children. They will be delighted. You also can see with this scope very well the Andromeda galaxy, the color of some stars. Another object that you can see very well and very nice with this scope. The Pleiades are beautiful with this refractor. This is a refractor, I forgot to say. So it works with lenses inside and not mirrors like the Dobsonians. So you can see, another feature that I have this very nice, I strongly recommend, it's the solar filter. I have a solar filter, I will show you. This is a thing that is not expensive. Make sure that you buy this one. Is still, this is aluminium. And it comes with the knobs. Yeah, see. And this is a nice filter. It has to be in the box, because it's it's not glass, but you buy this, it's cheap. I don't know, maybe 10, 15 euros, I don't know. You put this here. You don't have the night, you have the afternoon. You just put this here. This is very nice. This is a feature that, look, I in my 12-inch, I don't have a filter. When I want to look at the sun, I look with this filter. You just put this, like this, and you point to the sun. You have to cover, if you have a regal or a finery, this finery with the caps, you have to cover everything because the sun is it may damage. And tight well, and you will see the sun is very nice, especially if it's orange at the end of the day. It will be a very nice thing to do with this. Just don't put it, don't point it without the filter. So 70 millimeters, if you have a 80, better. If you have a 90 millimeters, better. If you had a 100, 120, you should be glad to have it. Mars not so well, because Mars you will see only orange. But Saturn you can see very well the rings, you can see Jupiter very well, the moons of Jupiter. And also, I don't use it for that. This is a telescope for terrestrial use, but that I don't use it. Every time I put the 12 inch out, there's always one children that come with it, because it's so light that I don't have to do nothing. They bring, they put this here, they use it, they have fun with it, they can put it again inside for themselves. I also bought, if you want to have more fun, I bought, you have on Amazon also, a smartphone adapter that you can put here. You fit here the adapter, you put the phone, and you have fun taking photos of the planets, of the moon, of the Pleiades. It will not be astrophotography professional art, but it will give you, for me, something more important. A lot of fun with your family, with your children, with your wife or husband, and you will not regret.